Answering these three questions are going to help you improve your SEO strategy. Which keywords are my audience using to find this content? Does the title persuade my audience to watch this video? Which thumbnail elements capture your video idea and your audience? Knowing these elements will increase your optimization strength and improve the chances of you getting a higher CTR. If you're not quite sure how to answer these, don't worry. Keyword Explorer, Title Generator, and Thumbnail Analyzer are three SEO tools that can help you answer these questions. But there's one more powerful tool that'll help put it all together. Let's learn how to use
SEO Studio.
Anyways, come on, let's open up SEO Studio. You can access a tool from the main menu, or you can access SEO Studio from the TB Tools menu. For now, let's start an SEO draft from scratch. I'm going to open up SEO Studio from the main menu and get going from here. Now, before we start cooking our SEO draft, we'll need to enter a target keyword. So this brings me to SEO tip number one. Use a long tail target keyword. So what do I mean by that? Well, the more specific that your keyword is, the better optimized your video can be. If you're not sure what phrase to use, try using Keyword Explorer to help you discover some of the ways that your viewers are finding content like yours. Remember, your video SEO will only be as good as the amount of research that you put in. So take your time and be selective. By the way, if you're new to keyword research, watch that video for some helpful tips. I'm going to use SEO Studio tips and tricks. Step one is where we're going to use our keywords to create a persuasive title and description. You can save time by applying one of your upload default templates, such as social media links or more. The SEO score here represents the amount of best practices that you've checked off this list. Make sure to check them all out. In case you're missing any, you'll notice that there's a red X, and as you add what's missing, SEO score will reflect that change. All right, let's create our title and description. By the way, if you don't have any title ideas yet, feel free to use our title generator. By the way, your target keyword will always be highlighted in green, and any partial matches will have a lighter shade of green everywhere else. This is kind of like a visual aid just to help you see how well you've optimized your video so far. Now, before I go on, this brings me to our SEO tip number two. Use selective keywords. If you're not using keywords that your audience is using to find content like yours, a 100 score isn't going to help you much. Avoid keyword stuffing and instead be selective about the keywords you're including naturally in your description. In other words, make sure that you're using other keyword phrases that are going to help boost your rankings. Use them in your description naturally so that your video can be as optimized as possible and rank as high as it can be. Okay, we're looking good so far, so let's keep moving. Step two is all about tags. Here you can manually add your tags. Also, click on import to go through some of your tag list and import that information here automatically. Big time saver. Or select one of the suggested tags at the bottom. The number next to it represents the Keyword Explorer score. I'd still recommend using Keyword Explorer to look through the data to make sure it makes sense for you. At the very least, make sure that it's relevant for the video. Now, before I move on, here is SEO tip number three. Use relevant misspelled keywords and odd search phrases. So one of the best ways to use tags is by finding how your audience misspells the content that you're making. But not only that, also find odd phrasing combinations that viewers can sometimes utilize. Tags like that are going to make the most impact on your video. Keep all the good keywords in your description and your title. Okay, let's move to step three. Now this is what I'm talking about. This right here, I'm all about this. Step three will let you upload a thumbnail so that you can compare how your video will look like in the current search results. This brings me to SEO tip number four, stand out from the crowd. It's great to be able to see an example of your video using your target keyword, but what's even better is that you can keep typing in different search phrases to see different results. For example, TubeBuddy SEO Studio tool.
This is huge.
This is an easy way to see how you stand out so that you can go back to the drawing board and optimize your thumbnail and title to make sure it stands out. In other words, use these search results to test your optimization. Okay, step four, we're pretty much done. Here, you can save your draft so that you can use it later or save it as a template to save you time in the future. If you're working on a video, you'll be able to apply those changes directly from here. After applying to the video, make sure to save your changes on YouTube. That way, the changes will take effect. And that's all there is to it. But I'll leave you with one more SEO tip. Number five, track your keywords. Use search positions to track your title, descriptions, and even your chapters. That way you can make modifications on the ones that aren't working and keep improving from there. Now, for the next time you're optimizing your videos, try using this TubeBuddy SEO combo. First, use Keyword Explorer to research selective and target keywords to use in your title and description. Next, use Title Generator to help create a persuasive title from one of your keywords that you've researched. Third, use Thumbnail Analyzer to check how effective your thumbnail ideas can be. Fourth, use SEO Studio to put it all together. And then fifth, use search positions to track the optimization strength of your keywords. Rinse and repeat this process as many times as you need to so that you're always improving your video's SEO and keeping up with changing trends along the way. And you'll be good to go. Remember that SEO Studio is here to guide you, not optimize the videos for you. It's critical that you research before using any of the keywords you've chosen to use in your titles and descriptions, and which attention-grabbing thumbnail elements you've decided to include. Because nobody's gonna know your audience better than you. Now get out there and start optimizing. You've got this. I believe in you. Get it? Get out there, drink your water, start optimizing.